Then we'll get started. Whoops, I forgot my mala beads today. Soles of our feet together, knees out wide.
Starting to connect with the breath. Breathing into a four count, holding to a four count, and exhaling to a four count. And as you breathe, breathe in through the belly, up through the ribs, the lungs, all the way to the tops of your throats. And then exhale in the opposite direction, from the tops of your throats, down through the ribs, the lungs, all the way to your bellies. And so you're wringing water from a washcloth, bringing navel in your spine. Again, perhaps place your right hands on your bellies and your left hands on your hearts. Contract the breath as it moves through your bodies. And let's begin. Inhale, two, three, four, hold, two, three, four, and exhale, two, three, four. Again, inhale, two, three, four, hold, two, three, four, and exhale, two, three, four. One more time, inhale, two, three, four, hold, two, three, four, and exhale, two, three, four. Now allow your breathing to come naturally to its own rhythm. Allow the warmth of your breath to go to any area of your body that is tense or sore, and allow the breath to relieve the tension or soreness that is there. Imagine your breath gathering up all of the tension and soreness in your bodies and breathing it out, so that you begin to feel peaceful and relaxed. Any distracting thoughts or feelings that you may have, allow them to be sent out with the breath. And as you breathe, allow yourselves to go deeper and deeper into this state of calm, knowing that you are in control at all times. Connect with a personal intention for this practice. That intention could be physical, mental, or spiritual. And it could be for you or for someone you love. Seal that intention with one deep inhale and one deep exhale. Good job. Inhale those knees and arms to center. Exhale, knees to the left, arms to the right. Look over your right shoulder and breathe. Again, breathing into this simple twist, opening up those right obliques as you do, releasing toxins from the weekend. Inhale. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, knees to the right, arms to the left. Look over that left shoulder and breathe again on this beautiful Monday. Opening up those left obliques as you do, releasing toxins. Inhale, back to center. Wrap your arms around your knees. Grab opposite elbows. Rock back and forth. Massage your lower back and your kidneys. And then grab on to your insteps. Drag your knees down towards your shoulder blades. Push up with your feet. Pull down with your hands. In happy baby. Again, dragging those shoulders back and down. Breathing in and out. In happy baby. And then come back to center, cross that right leg over left, wrap your feet, right arm under left, wrap your arms. Inhale as you touch your fingers and toes to the mat. Open up. Exhale, elbows to knees, eagle crunches. Inhale, back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale, back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Two more or seven more, wherever you are. Inhale, back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale, back. Exhale, elbows to knees. You can stop here or follow us. Inhale, back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale, back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale, back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Two more. Inhale, back. Exhale, forward. Inhale, back. And exhale, forward. Again, slowly and with purpose. Unwrap, unwind, give yourselves a hug. Then cross that left leg over right. Wrap your feet. Left arm under right. Wrap your arms. Eagle arms, eagle legs. Inhale as you touch your fingers and toes to the mat. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale, back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale, back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Two more or seven more. Inhale, back. Exhale, forward. Inhale, back. Exhale, forward. And again, you can stop here or follow us. Inhale, back. Exhale, forward. Inhale, back. Exhale, forward. Inhale, back. Exhale, forward. Two more. Inhale, back. Exhale, forward. Inhale, back. And exhale, forward. Good job. Unwrap, unwind, give yourselves a hug. Good job. And then from here, inhale first and exhale those legs down to the end of the mat. Roll over onto the left side, left elbow, left palm of your hand down. And as you can see, I do have my mala beads on. I don't know why I was not seeing them as I was backing up. Inhale that right leg in. Grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you. And again, drag that right shoulder back and down. If you've been hiking this weekend, you might be just a little tight. This is a wonderful way to open up before practice. Again, maybe grab onto your calf if this is in your practice. Dragging that right knee in, exhale down to the end of the mat. Roll over onto the right side, right elbow, right palm of your hand down. Inhale that left knee in, grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you, drive that left shoulder back and down. Left hip down. And again, possibly grab onto your calf, drag your leg towards you if this is in your practice. In infinity pose. Inhale that left knee in. Exhale down to the end of the mat. Draw your knees in, spinal rolls from shoulder to tailbone and back again, allowing each vertebra to come back into alignment. We'll do three or four of these. And arrive at the tops of our mats. It's Utkatasana, simple seated pose, crisscross applesauce. Good job. Place your hands on your knees. Feel that crown chakra directly above your root chakra. And then we're going to inhale gratitude. Exhale any negative energy we may be holding on to from this weekend. Inhale those arms all the way up. Exhale down. As you inhale, inhale through your noses. As you exhale, sigh it out. Inhale all the way up. And exhale. Good job. One last time. Inhale all the way up. And exhale down. From here, place your hands on your knees. Inhale that left arm all the way up. Exhale down to the right, onto the right elbow. Look up towards the ceiling. Drag your left hip, left shoulder back and down. Open up those left obliques once again. Feel that energy coursing from your left hip all the way up through your left fingertips. Smile. It's Monday. Inhale back to center. Exhale first. Inhale that right arm up. And exhale down to the left. Look up towards the ceiling. Again, dragging that right hip, right shoulder back and down. Feeling that energy moving. Your right hip all the way up the side of your right body to your right fingertips. Inhale back to center. Good job. And then from here, extend your legs in front of you. Flex your feet. Inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale as you open up to the right. Extend that right arm behind you. And drag that left elbow on the outside of your right knee. Again, you can either be on the outside of your right knee, in between your knees, left knee, wherever you are is perfect. Make mudras with both sets of fingers. Twisted Dandasana. Inhale back up again. Exhale as you open up to the left. Drag that right elbow down. Open up, make mudras with both sets of fingers. Shoulders are back and down. Inhale back to center. Exhale, reach, 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 reach. Reach, 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 reach. Hands come down on either side of your calves. Inhale, halfway up. And exhale down, chin to shin, and then just curl in, Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you bend your left knee, drive your left heel in. Inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale all the way down this time. Half Dandasana, chin to shin. And then just curl in. Inhale back to center. Exhale as you draw that left knee to center. Good job. Let's go ahead and let's see. Inhale that left arm up. Grab your, let's see. I'm sorry. This has been a while. Let's place your left shoulder so that it's the same height as your left knee. And then reach back with your left hand. Reach back with your right hand, opening up to the right as much as possible. Breathing in and out. Opening your heart to the sidewall through the breath. Inhale back to center, cross that left foot over your right knee. Inhale that right arm up. Exhale as you place it on the outside of your left knee. Open up to the back of the room. Twisting, releasing toxins, breathing in and out. Inhale back to center. Exhale as you extend your legs and shake them out. Good job. Inhale first and exhale as you draw that right heel in. Flex that left foot. Inhale both arms all the way up. And exhale, fold forward, hand to the hips, reach, 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 reach. Chin to shin and then just curl in. In half Dandasana, half staff pose. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you draw that right knee in. Place your right shoulder so that it's parallel with your right knee. Reach back with your right hand. Reach back with your left hand. Clasp hands and open up to the sidewall through the breath. Again, twisting, releasing toxins. Inhale back to center. Cross that right leg over left. Inhale that left arm up. Exhale as you bend your elbow, placing it on the outside of your right knee and open up to the back of the room. So to the side wall, making mudras with your left hands. Breathing in and out. Inhale back to center. Exhale as you extend your legs and shake them out. Good job. And then from here, bend your legs, cross your feet. Place your hands on the mat and roll up into table. In table, our shoulders are above our wrists, our hips are above our knees, and if we look between our legs, we shouldn't see our feet. Inhale that right arm all the way up. Exhale as you thread it under, coming down onto that right shoulder, keep your hips square to the front of the room. Inhale that left arm up, bend your elbow, find that right hip crease. And breathe again and thread the needle, opening your heart to the sidewall through the breath. Inhale, that left arm up. Exhale down. Inhale, that right arm all the way up. And exhale down. Good job. Other side, inhale that left arm all the way up. Exhale as you cross under, coming down onto that left shoulder. Square your hips to the front of the room. Inhale that right arm up. Bend your elbow, find that left hip crease and breathe. Inhale that right arm up. Exhale down. Inhale that left arm all the way up. And exhale down. Good job. And then from here,
take these broken wings.
Let's go ahead and do some cat cows. So we're going to go ahead and first inhale. Now drag your spines down, look up towards the ceiling. Exhale, bending those elbows as you transition into cat. Drag your spines all the way up. Inhale. Now.
You are only waging
the exhale. Good job. One last time. Inhale.
Into the line of a dark black line.
And exhale. Cat, good job. Come back to a flat back. And then from here, curl your toes under, sit back on your heels. Making infinity symbols with your wrists, opening up your wrists, opening up your toes, breathing in and out. Again, you could stay here, you can draw those arms up overhead, drag your shoulders back and down. You can also draw those hands behind you. Fingertips touch, pushing your fingertips up towards the crowns of your heads. Hands are in Anjali Mudra behind your back. Opening up your shoulders, your wrists, your fingers, and your toes. Good job, everyone. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Rock forward on your elbows. Slap up your toes. Good job. And then from here, plant the palms of your hands into the mat. Curl your toes under. Inhale first. Exhale back to down dog. Again, opening up your calf muscles by perhaps lifting first one heel and then the other, dragging the other heel down towards the mat, flattening out your backs, dragging your arms towards your thighs, in Ardha Bhujangasana, downward facing dog, baby walking the dog, lifting first one heel and then the other. Good job. Come up on your tippy toes, bend your knees, look towards the front of the mat, drag those shoulders back and down. Step or jump up. Inhale, halfway up. The Ardha. Again, Ardha Tadasana. Exhale, down to Uttanasana. Standing forward fold. Slightly bend your knees. Inhale all the way up. Swan back backward. Hands come together. Slight back bend. And hands come to Anjali Mudra. Bowing our heads in honor of our practices. Good job. Now we're going to turn towards the front of the room, which you might already be doing, but I'll do this myself. Inhale both arms all the way up. Grab onto that left wrist with your right hand. And exhale over to the right as far as you can, standing crescent. Again, as you're doing this, perhaps point that left toe out. Move even more into the pose. Feel that energy coursing from your left toe all the way to your fingertips. Inhale back to center. Grab onto your right wrist with your left hand. Exhale over to the left. And again, you can either stay here in standing crescent or point that right toe, moving more in to the asana. Inhale back to center. Exhale those hands down. Draw your hands to Venus Mudra behind you. Shoulders are back and down. Open your hearts. Inhale first. Exhale. Hinge at the hips. Humbly bow yourselves. Good job. Maybe allow those wrists to come towards the center of the room with gravity if this is in your practice. Breathing in and out. Drag those wrists back towards your waist. Release. Inhale, halfway up to Ardha. Look towards the front of the room. Exhale down to Uttanasana. Again, palms of our hands are on the mat. Slightly bend your knees, inhale all the way up. One dive backward, hands come together. Slight back bend. And hands come to Anjali Mudra. Bowing our heads in honor of our practices. Good job. And then from here, we're going to start our sequencing. Inhale those arms all the way up. Exhale, swan dive down. Inhale, halfway up. Step or jump back. Go through your vinyasa or meet us in down dog. Walking the dog. Good job. Inhale, that left leg all the way up. Three-legged dog split. Exhale, swing it forward. Plant your back foot. Inhale up to Virabhadrasana 1. Good job. Draw those hands behind you once again to Venus Mudra. Shoulders are back and down. Inhale first. Exhale, humbly bow yourselves once again inside of that right thigh this time. Dragging the crowns of your heads down towards the mat, allowing your wrists to open towards the front of the room with gravity if this is in your practice. Draw them back towards your waist before you release, opening up north and south into side angle. Possibly draw that arm overhead. If this is in your practice, and then open up once again, take a wrap, possibly take a bind, reach under and grab that left wrist, opening your hearts to the side all through the breath. Then open up once again, place that left hand down. Swivel up on the ball of your left foot and place your right hand beside your left hand. Allow that right knee to fall open with gravity. And then possibly come down on your elbows. Possibly place your thumbs on your third eye. In lizard, opening up that right hip. Inhale as you plant that right hand into the mat. Swivel that left foot around. Open up to side angle. Look down. Inhale all the way up. To Virabhadrasana 2. Cartwheel those arms down. Take that right leg back. And go to your vinyasa. Or meet us in down dog. Inhale through your noses, side out. Inhale. One more time. Inhale. Good job. Inhale. That left leg all the way up. Three-legged dog split. Exhale. Swing it through to a lunge. Plant your back foot. Inhale up. Virabhadrasana 1 on the left side. Pinky fingers in. Draw your hands back to Venus Mudra. Inhale first. Exhale as you humbly bow yourselves inside of that left thigh, allowing your wrists to come towards the center of the room with gravity. Draw them back towards your waist before you release. Open up north and south into side angle. And again, possibly draw that right arm up above you in the Uttita. Open up once again, and then possibly take a wrap, maybe take a bind. Reach under and grab that right wrist. Looking up towards the ceiling. Open up north and south. And then place that right hand down. Swivel up on the ball of your right foot. Place that left hand down. Allow your left knee to fall open with gravity. Come down onto your elbows, if this is in your practice. Maybe place your thumbs on your third eye. Open up that left hip as you do in lizard. Inhale as you press into the mat with your left hand. Swivel around on that right foot. Open up to side angle. Look down, inhale all the way up to Virabhadrasana 2. Cartwheel those arms down. Kick that left leg back. And go through your vinyasa. Or meet us in down dog. Good job. Inhale through your noses, side out. Inhale. One more time, inhale. Inhale, that right leg all the way up. Three-legged dog split. Exhale as you swing it to the top left of your mat. Right knee down, left knee down. Left top of foot down. Inhale as you walk your hands back. Possibly take Venus Mudra. And exhale as you humbly bow yourself. Coming down onto that left cheek in resting pigeon. Possibly drag those hands back towards your waist. You can be on your left cheek, you can be on your elbows, you can be on your right cheek. Again, we're in resting pigeon, releasing any unwanted emotion that you may be storing there. I'm grateful that today I will be hosting an afterlife panel for the Open to Hope International Day of Hope and Healing After Loss is the name of the conference, and it's based out of New York, but they're going to be doing it from California today. And I think that there will be thousands of people joining from all over the world. And I'm looking forward to it, but it's always difficult because we only have 25 minutes total for the panel, and I have four experts that I'm speaking with. So it's a little stressful every time because I don't want anybody to speak for too long a time. And I don't want to interrupt the specialists either. So much nicer to have a little bit longer, actually. Again, may hold this just a bit longer today. Getting rid of any negative emotions, anything negative that you're holding on to from the weekend. In resting pigeon. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Come off on that right hip. Swing your left leg all the way around. Left foot is parallel to your right thigh. Bring that right foot in and that right elbow in. Inhale that left arm up and around. Find your right hip crease. Possibly take a bind if this is in your practice. And breathe. Breathing in and out. Releasing toxins. Massaging our internal organs in the Varyandrasana triple twist. Inhale back to center. Extend your legs and shake them out. Come up to the tops of your mats in Malasana and Yogi Squat. And again, you can stay here with the backs of your biceps just below your knees. You can also rock forward if you like to, if this is in your practice, into Bakasana, lifting your toes, tail feathers come together. Wherever you are is perfect. And again, you can stay here as we inhale from our root chakra all the way up to our crown chakra, and exhale down again. Inhale. Exhale. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. Place your hands on the mat. Inhale halfway up. Exhale as you take a giant step back. Put that right foot. Walk your left foot all the way across. Left knee down, right knee down, right top of foot down. Inhale as you walk those hands back. Take Venus Mudra and exhale down, this time onto your right cheek if this is in your practice. Again, drag your wrist back towards your waist before you release. I just did an interview with a beautiful lady in Italy yesterday. It's a online conference, and she's from South Africa, and her husband was a marathon runner, and he had a devastating heart attack the last time he was running a marathon and had a near-death experience. So she asked him what he wanted to do, and they had a summer home in Italy with the rest of his life, and he said, I want to do motorcycle tours in Italy. So they packed everything up, moved to Italy. He recovered. He was out on the road on a motorcycle testing out a route when they first got there, and he passed in a motorcycle accident. So they had just gotten to Italy during COVID, and there was quarantine in Italy. It was quite bad, and her next door neighbor kindly brought her food and would put it on her doorstep, and they talked to each other through the windows. Sounds like Romeo and Juliet, and they fell in love and they're now married, which is really an amazing story. But anyway, I spoke to her about my shared death experience with Morgan. Inhale as you walk your hands back. Coming off on that left hip, swing your right leg all the way around. Right foot is parallel to your left thigh. Bring that left foot in and that left elbow in. Inhale, that right arm up and around. Find your left hip crease. Possibly take a bind if this is in your practice. Again, in the Mariandrasana twist. Inhale back to center. Extend your legs and shake them out. Good job. Bend your knees. Arms are out on either side of your knees. Inhale first. Exhale inch by inch. Vertebra by vertebra down to the mat. And when you get there, draw those knees in for a much deserved hug. Rock back and forth. Massage your lower backs and your kidneys. Good job. And then from here, place your heels just below your sit bones. Block in hand, inhale as you push your hips up, placing the block underneath your sacrum on the highest, second, or third levels, wherever you are is perfect. Again, in a supported bridge, you can be here, walk your feet forward, you can draw those arms overhead if you'd like to, wherever you are is perfect. Again, this is a T formation or a mushroom formation. Draw those arms back overhead. Walk your feet in. Inhale as you push your hips up, releasing the block, then exhale down. Inhale your legs straight up. Into the legs straight up, allowing the circulation to come back down to your vital organs, back down to your brain, if this is in your practice. You can also move into a shoulder stand, pushing your hips up, walking your shoulders under. Feet are in Barbie feet, looking like a candlestick. Possibly draw those legs overhead, if this is in your practice, into Halasana or cloud pose. Again, be gentle with yourself. Maybe bend your knees, placing your knees around your ears in ear pressure pose or snail pose. And then inch by inch, vertebra by vertebra, coming down to the mat. Draw those knees in for a hug. Rock back and forth. Massage your lower backs and your kidneys. Inhale through your noses, side out. Inhale. Place your feet as wide as the mat. Arms are out east and west. Inhale first. Exhale as you allow your knees to fall all the way down to the left.
when the rain set in. And your footsteps will always fall.
Windshield wipers. Inhale back to center. Exhale down. To the right. Once again, inhale to center. Exhale down to the left.
Loveliness we lost. Empty days without.
Inhale back to center. And exhale down to the right.
Even though we try.
Inhale to center. Draw those knees in for a hug. Once again, inhale through your nose, side out, inhale. One more time, inhale. And with that intention, allow your legs to come out as wide as the mat or wider. Arms are down beside your torso. Palms are up to receive, down to ground, starting to relax. Relax your toes, relax your feet, relax your ankles. Relax your calves, relax your knees, relax your thighs. Relax your hips, relax your torsos, relax your fingers. Relax your hands, relax your wrists, relax your forearms. Relax your elbows, relax your upper arms. Relax your shoulders. Relax your necks, relax your jaws, relax your cheeks. Relax your foreheads. Relax the crowns of your heads. Just relax. Start to bring movement back to your fingers and your toes by wiggling your toes and maybe touching each finger with your thumb. Reach your arms overhead, extend through your feet, giving yourselves a full body stretch and filling your lungs with your breath. Then exhale as you draw those knees in for one final compassionate hug, rocking back and forth. Slowly roll over to the right side in the fetal position and remain here for a few breaths. Then using the strength of your arms, come back to a seated position facing the front of the room. Legs are crossed, hands are at Anjali Mudra, heads are bowed in honor of your practices. From the place deep in my soul that I know to be pure and true, I bow to and honor that same place that resides within each of you. Thank you so much for coming to practice yoga with me on this beautiful Monday. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and I will see you tomorrow. Namaste. Thank you all. And by the way, this International Day of Hope and Healing is free to everyone. And all you have to do is register to get the link. And it's on our Instagram, Helping Parents Heal Instagram. If anybody would like to see, there's going to be David Kessler and a whole bunch of other, Paul Denniston, and lots of interesting people. Suzanne's going to be on there, Suzanne Giesman, as well as Jeffrey Olson, Jeff O'Driscoll, and Christopher Kerr, Dr. Christopher Kerr as well, and lots of other fun people. So anyway, it'll be starting, I believe, at 9 o'clock our time. So
Have a wonderful rest of the day. It's great to see everybody. I'm going to stop recording.